Are we rolling? Cool. Hi everybody. Welcome to this new webcast format, which is on Facebook Live. A little bit daunting, but here we go. Hopefully you're just joining us. So today, basically, the memo from the boss said that the kind of concept of this little chat would be summer songs, or sounding like your favourite summer hits and stuff like that. So I've got a couple of tunes that I'll play to that I think were kind of big in the summer, or they remind me of summer myself. We've got a couple of amps that we're using. We've got the two probably most current products that we have at Blackstar. We have here the brand new ID Core 100. Which there's two in the range. There's a 150 and a 100 watt, 2x10 configuration, and they're part of the ID Core range, so they use a lot of the same styles of voices, but this time there's a few tweaks with these new products. Obviously they're bigger, they're louder, they're made for live use, as opposed to the original ID Core, which were very successful for us as a practice amplifier, but lots of people were asking if they could use them live, and not really. I would say that if you had a great PA system and a double mic set up like this, then possibly. But there's little hints that make it obvious that it's not for that. For example, the speakers in there are full range, which is ideal for home practice and recording and that kind of stuff. And also, if you were to use the emulated signal, the line out, either for headphones or direct connection to a PA, it would disable the speakers internally. But obviously, with this one, it wouldn't do that. So you can utilize miking the amplifier as well as the emulated out, which is super cool. There's also a few tweaks on the voicing side of things, because these are using proper guitar loudspeakers this time. And we've got a built-in looper with 30 seconds looping time. And also there's a built-in octaver as well, which is super good fun. Needless to say, it's a beautiful amp, lots of tones from clean to scream. And the first thing I'm going to do really is talk a little bit about the clean tones on here, because it's a really, really nice sound. Especially for a single core guitar, which is what you're basically hearing there. I've just split my guitar on the coils there, so it's basically like a five-way Strat sort of thing. So on the second position there, it was kind of giving me that vibe of that Nile Rodgers funk sort of sound, you know? That sort of really nice. And if we add some phaser onto that, there's four modulations as well as four reverbs and four delays. So this is a phaser. So that's a little bit too much. I want more of a subtle phase. And the cool thing about our effects and the way they're set out on our digital products is you can really get detailed editing on board the amplifier. So I'm going to tap the tempo to make it a lot slower. And I'm going to just decrease the segment and the overall level of the effect. So it's definitely in there. I'm going to add a little bit more reverb, a little bit more level there. Cool. You can add some delay maybe as well. And these amps, of course, feature super wide stereo. If you've never tried super wide stereo, and believe me, there's still a lot of people that think they know what it is. Traveling around the UK recently, I was in Scotland for a week, and lots of people saying, oh yeah, I love those ID Core amps. And I was kind of saying, well, the super wide stereo, what do you think? And, yeah, it's cool. It's got two speakers. You need to really physically hear it to give you the full experience, because it sounds like three-dimensional and it really immerses you within the effects that are on board. You have to be in front of the amp, playing the amp, to really experience that. But it's a superb effects system. It really is. But we don't necessarily need delay for this one. Bit of reverb and phase would do. And this is a song that I'm just going to jam along a little bit with. Nile Rodgers, of course, Cheek, all the stuff he's done over the years. Great funk guitar player, underrated, sits back in the groove, but very, very recognisable, you know. You know, everyone knows those songs. So here's more of a recent one that he played on. That it was a really big summer hit, so hopefully you'll know it. Works really well with that track. Just a really nice pure clean. I'm using a clean warm voicing. The ISF is more towards the American side of things, getting that sort of F sound, you know, that, you know, more scooped, tighter. Really nice. So let's move on to a slightly different sound, shall we? Maybe something along the lines of a more of a high gain sort of thing. Maybe I'll switch to humbucker now. Let's add some delay in there. I think we might have some questions, actually. Yeah, so somebody's asking if the effects are the same as the core. They are essentially, but the modulation is where the change has happened. So if you're familiar with ID Core and ID Series, on the modulations you typically would have phaser, flanger, chorus, and then tremolo through the segments. But to make room for the brand new octava on ID Core High Power, the flanger and the chorus have been blended into the second segment. So you can get some really cool in-between sounds as well. but typically you can still find everything you need from what you would expect a flanger to do, and also a chorus, but it left open the octave effect. If I show you what the octave effect can do, let's turn the delay off for a second. So, at the beginning of the segment, the smallest part of the segment, again, third segment on modulations, is a low octave. On the thicker part of the segment, it's a high octave. And the level of the effect becomes a wet and a dry mix between your guitar signal and the octave signal. Now, there's a few cool things you can do with that. For example, if we're using a clean tone right now, of course that sounds pretty good on clean. Let's increase the level. Really cool tracking on there as well, you know. Octave pedals aren't cheap either, so the fact that it's built into this product is really, really a good plus. So what you can do if I'm using a clean, just to give you an example, if I scroll through the segment, you start to get the higher octave. So if we bring the level down, so it's more of a minimal mix, we can start to recreate that sort of 12-string sound, if you like. That classic Hard Day's Night sort of chord. It takes you right there to that sort of 12-string, Ricky sort of sound. The other thing we can do with that is if we give the guitar signal a bit more of a lower octave as well. So it's a good mixture between the two. We can get some really, really nice ethereal sort of shimmering effects as well. Check this out with some volume swells. Really cool, which you would expect to get that sort of effect from a really expensive pedal, but it's all built in and fully programmable and assignable to your foot switches and so on. Another thing we can do, if we get rid of that really large reverb, we can go for a low octave. We can go for more of a high gain sort of sound. Which is really, really something as well. And these amps really perform when they're cranked. They're built for live use. So no matter how much you push it, it doesn't start rattling and moving around and feels as though it's gonna let you down. It really, really delivers loud. And when I was showing this around up the north, Scotland last week, everybody was well impressed. Really, really cool. So going back to playing along to another summary sort of track, let's go for a nice super crunch. Let's go for more of a British sort of tone stack on the ISF. Let's add some delay in there as well. Maybe a bit less on the level. It's kind of cool. And we want some reverb, but we want to shorten it from what we were last using. There we go, that sounds pretty good to me. So we're going to play along with an Alice Cooper track. And interestingly, this takes me back a few months to when I was playing with Nita Strauss, doing a webcast at Blackstar HQ, and that was really cool fun. And we got to play, I think it was Poison by Alice Cooper together. And I went to see them live a few times on that tour. Obviously, because Tommy Henriksen and Nita are both using Blackstar products, it was really cool to hear them loud and punching and awesome tone. So I thought I'd try an Alice Cooper song. I've only just learnt this briefly before we started this Facebook Live, but we'll see how we get on. But it's definitely a summery tune, and I'm sure you'll know it. Let's see how we go. That was good fun. Mistakes free, remember. I've only just learnt that song. But yeah, I think we got another question flying.
Yeah, so is it full range speakers in the...
No. These are proper guitar loudspeakers this time. So playing an MP3 player through here, I was just using the tracks from my phone. I've just got a 3.5mm jack going from here into the 3.5mm input, MP3 input on the back. It sounds pretty good for practicing and using it for music, but the ID Core is probably a little bit clearer because it's full range, flat response essentially. So like we said earlier, the full range speakers, how's that home practice thing? Do you know what I mean? This is really built for super loud, super lightweight, super compact. That's the essence of this product. Okay, you've got another question? Yeah.
Are the preamps the same as ID Core or ID Series or?
No, they've been revoiced for specifically for these two amps. Obviously there are some similarities there. There's two cleans, two crunch and two overdrive, specifically clean warm, clean bright, crunch, super crunch, OD1, OD2. The overdrives still have the noise gate on them that can be taken off or altered with a threshold via the insider software. So essentially the voices are the same. It's what you would expect from Blackstar, but they've been revoiced specifically for this product. So it's kind of cool. Okay, so that's the ID Core High Power. The next product we're going to look at is the Artist. We've got an Artist 15 here. Oops, I'm losing my stuff, man. Okay. So, the Artist 15 is our first valve amp for a while. And it really is built for the pedal guitar player or the guitar player that uses any sort of larger multi-effects or single stop boxes. We've got a couple of my favourites here that I constantly carry around with me. These are part of the LT range of our pedals. This is a boost, which is a natural boost, and also we've got an LT drive here, which is an overdrive pedal. But essentially what we've got with the Artist series amp is there's two channels, and it's not your typical clean and dirty that you would expect. It's more a case of there's two clean versions of two different channels, basically. The first channel is very much like a Class A British sort of barking clean. So it's simple. It's got volume and tone, but it's really, really versatile through that tone stack. Let's give you a couple of examples of that. With the tone roughly about 2 o'clock. If we lower the tone all the way, it's really nice, warm, jazzy sort of sound. If we get it all the way up, it's more of a trebled push sound. Very much a boutique sort of thing, you know, old school. We've got a reverb on there, you can hear that there. There's a touch of reverb. It's a digital reverb circuit, but very, very realistic to a spring. So my kind of preference is around about the 2 o'clock position on the tone. The volume is roughly around about 3 o'clock. And we've got the master according to the environment we're in. But this is a 15-watt version. And we do a 30-watt combo as well. The difference is really the wattage, and also this is a 112, the 30-watt is a 212. But I really, really recommend that you try this if you're a pedal guy. You know, if you're looking for that V-type sound or that F-type sort of sound, Blackstar now have a product in their range that's at a good price point. And it's based around the essence of our original Artisan series, which is a hand-wired boutique clean amp, basically, unless you push it all the way to 11 and you're in the world of Townsend and Angus, basically. This is the second channel. This is more of a Class AB. I'll do a closer representation. For me, the second channel is a little bit more of an American sort of sound. So this is channel one. Two. Pedals and stomp boxes also react differently as well. So let's just engage the drive. I've got a minimal drive sort of thing, like a blues sort of sound on channel one. So this, here's our clean. This is adding the boost as well, so we're stacking it. Now over to channel two using the same pedals. Handles pedals extremely well, and I've got a couple of different boards that I use for playing live, and I've tried many pedals on these amps and they just work great. So like I said, if you're after that sort of F-type American sort of sound or that V-type British sort of sound, then definitely check out the Blackstar Artist. I think we might have a question coming through, yeah.
Speaker configuration, what speakers are you?
The speakers in here are Celestion V-type, so they're very much a vintage 30 sort of feel, a little bit lighter, a little bit less expensive, I guess, but they still sound really, really good. It's definitely a top speaker from Celestion, yeah.
So how many?
This is the 1x12 in the 15, and I mentioned earlier the Artist 30 has 212. So it's just two combos. Combos are very much a popular thing right now, so.
Can you ask another question about the cabinet, what wood?
Yeah, the cabinet is ply. It's good quality, it's solid, it's lightweight as well. A lot of people that pick these combos up generally are quite surprised by just how light they are, you know, considering some of the older style amps in the same clean sort of vein, you know.
Also, sorry, one more. About the
valves? Valves are 6L6s, same in both. So the 6L6 valve is very commonly known for, I guess, American style amps, but there's lots of headroom, very little compression, so you're getting the true sound of the amplifier and the true sound of your guitar, basically. So yeah, 6L6s for your power valves, yeah. Or tubes for you American dudes. Okay, so I think we're going to play along to a track before we end this first Facebook Live. So thanks for tuning in. I hope you've enjoyed it. It's just a little bit of information from myself, the product trainer, about some of our new products. The ID Core high-powered 100, we do a 150, the Artist 15, and we do a 30 as well. So this is your digital, this is your valve. So two current products. And to end on, I think we're gonna play, let me sort out a tone first. So I've got a nice little selection there of clean through to drive, through to a little bit more sting with the boost pedal. And we'll play to one more track. We'll see if we can get this done in such a way whereby the audio is coming through the ID Core 100 and my guitar is coming through the Artist 15. So again, thanks very much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed it and we'll see you again soon. Thanks a lot.
I got my first real six string, bought it at the five and dime, played it till my fingers bled, was the summer of 69. Me and some guys from school had a band and we tried real hard. Jimmy quit, Jody got married, should've known we'd never get far.
So there you go. Thank you very much for watching. Summer Vibes. First time I've done a webcast on Facebook Live. So thanks very much for watching. See you soon.